Please rest on your back. Take a moment to arrive in the room and arrive on the floor. And as you do that, pay particular attention to your shoulder blades. And just notice, are they foggy or clear for you? Whether it's foggy or clear, it's all information. And you might refine your attention and notice the pressure behind the right shoulder blade. Does it seem evenly distributed, or is there more pressure on the tip of the shoulder blade or up towards the top of the torso? Does it feel flat, or is there some part protruding or angling into the floor? And the same with the left shoulder blade. There's no judgment about this, whether it's clear or foggy, resting or not resting. You just notice. If you were to tie a string from the left earlobe to the left shoulder joint, and likewise from the right earlobe to the right shoulder joint, which string would be longer? And for some people, that image will make sense, and for others, it won't make any sense at all. So you use what works for you in these lessons. And some things might make complete sense for you, so those are the things that you use. Take an internal measurement of the length of the right side of your torso from underneath the right armpit, all the way down through the ribs and the waist, all the way down to the bony part of the pelvis. And compare that to the left side of yourself, from the left armpit, all the way down the left side, the ribs, the waist, to that bony shelf of the pelvis. Does one feel longer or shorter? Avoid any impulse to shift yourself so that you get a clean observation, so to speak. And then let that go and bring your feet to stand. Interlace your fingers, bring them behind the head. And for this lesson, let the elbows rest out to the sides, which is not usual for Feldenkrais, but that's what we're doing here. Slide your head a little bit right and a little bit left in the palms of the hands, so the knuckles are going to slide on the floor. So the nose stays toward the ceiling. And the elbows slide, one points up and one points down. And the shoulders slide a little on the floor. And do less than you can. Don't strain as if a huge movement has more merit, because it doesn't. Just track your experience as you shift the upper trunk and one elbow points a little down. And what's comfortable for you at this moment? And maybe half an inch is comfortable. So if you continue to use your measure of comfort as the main variable, then by the end, when you use the same measure, you can observe if the movement is actually different. Really feel the ribs, the breastbone, the feet, the pelvis. How do they participate or not participate in this movement? And then rest, come back to center, and uninterlace your hands and pause with your arms alongside your torso. You can leave the knees bent. And now bring the right hand behind the head. So the back of the head is resting in the palm of the right hand, and if comfortable, you can let the elbow hang out to the side. Slide the head and the hand and the arm to the right and back to center. And just saying that, slide the head, what does that mean? There are many strategies for this. So one strategy is to leave the ribs exactly where they are and only move in the neck. It's actually hard to do just in the neck, if not impossible, because you're holding the head with the arm and it involves the shoulder girdle. And then do a few more movements like this and feel what happens to the left side of your ribs and notice, are they involved in your strategy? Pause with your head to the right and feel the left side of your ribs. Could you breathe into the left ribs? Imagine the ribs widening, kind of pushing out a little bit further to the left. Breathe into the left side of the ribs and imagine the neck could lengthen a little bit as you do that. Could that breathing assist you in bringing the head a half an inch further to the right? Just continue breathing into the left ribs, lengthening and widening. Where do you feel your attention is drawn in this movement? Could you soften the neck, soften the waist? Then slide back to the center and again, slide over to the right a couple of times and just feel how it is. Pause in the middle, take the right hand out from behind the head, lower the legs and rest. How do you lie on the floor now? And what's the difference in the length of the two sides of the torso? The pressure on the shoulder blades? Please stand both your feet again. Bring the right hand behind the head, same hand. Get a hold of the right elbow with the left hand. So you're reaching over the head to the right elbow with the left hand. Don't strain to do this. If you can't reach the elbow, don't go that far. So you modify the movement. Start to slide the head to the right and back to center, with your left hand wherever it could be comfortably. So the left hand helps to push and pull on the right elbow. And of course I say head slides to the right, but there's more of you involved. Feel how the shoulders slide. Observe what happens in your ribs, left and right. Can you sense the right elbow pointing a little bit towards your feet? What happens in your collarbones, your shoulder blades, the space in between the shoulder blades? Don't go as far as you feel any strain, because that will inhibit your learning. You will find that is a theme throughout all of Feldenkrais, and it will be repeated many times. Can you feel that you're eliminating most of the activity in the neck? Right? The neck is carried. The movement of the ribs carries the head and neck. Maybe the feet or the pelvis have something to say. Pause to the right. Leave your head over there. Lengthen your left leg long. So your right foot is somewhere stable and comfortable. Press with your right foot to lift the right hip and then bring it back to the floor. And again, press with the right foot and do it a few times, feeling how the belly button rolls a little to the left. And can you make yourself comfortable in this funny position? And what does this movement ask of your skeleton? Do you immediately hold your breath, grit your teeth? If there's any strain, do less. It's a strong constraint, so go very gently. There's no work in the belly. The belly's responsive. It's not initiating. Slide back to the center with your head and your arms. Leave your head and arms in the center, and from there, lift and lower the right hip by pushing through the right foot. And feel how that's different. And the knee, the right knee, doesn't tilt to the side. It actually stays over the foot. So it's as if your knee is pushing over the toes. The knee doesn't go to the left. Where do you need to soften to be comfortable? And after you've done a few movements with the head and arms in the middle, slide them over to the right again. And do a few gentle movements like that. Again, the right knee stays vertical. After you've done a few movements like that, slide your head and arms back to the middle. Bring your arms alongside your torso, lower your right leg and rest. And find out, did you do too much? I recommend doing an eighth of what you can do. If you do too much and you push to the end of the movement, what you'll likely be doing is engaging with your habits. And we want to fly under the radar of your habits. So do a little less. In fact, do way less. And see how it affects you. You know, test one lesson doing an enormously small amount and discover in your own self what happens. You know, don't take anybody's word for it, but test it on your own experience. Roll your head a little side to side and notice if it feels different going to one side than the other. And then leave the head in the middle. Bend both your knees. Stand both your feet. Bring your right hand behind your head, the same hand. Get a hold of the right elbow with the left hand, if that's possible and comfortable. And once or twice, slide the head to the right and back to center. And notice how it goes. The nose stays toward the ceiling. That's a constraint. Bring your head somewhere to the right comfortably and leave it there. Lengthen the right leg down long. Your left leg is standing. Have the left foot somewhere supportive, so it's skeletally supportive. Push through the left foot and lift the left hip and then lower it again. Do that a number of times, gently, easily. Invite the spine to change shape. The left knee stays vertical. That's also a constraint. It might extend over the toes a bit, but it doesn't tilt left or right. Feel what happens in your ribs, the waist. And you can test different positions of the left foot. For some people, the organization will be useful further out from the midline. So where do you feel the most skeletal support through the lower leg bones so the pressure of the foot transfers easily and directly into the hip? The next time your left hip is down, could you bring the head and shoulders a little further to the right? Is that a possibility? If you can, go a little further to the right, and then lift and lower the left hip again, but only if it's in your range of comfort. Leave the left hip down and slowly slide your head and arms back to center. Unwind the arms. Lower the arms alongside you. Lower the left leg and rest. Feel your ribs on both sides. Stand both your feet, bend both your knees. Bring your right hand behind your head. Get a hold of the right elbow with the left hand if that's comfortable for your left arm and shoulder. Check in with your feet that they're in a good spot, they're supporting you. Slide the head and the shoulders and the upper torso to the right and back to center. And what's that like? And just notice if it is different. You don't have to analyze why it's different, but use your sensory feedback to notice if it's different. Now, sometimes mobilizing the left ribs creates a big difference for people. In fact, mobilizing any ribs creates a big difference. Go to the place where you feel that that's the point where you go comfortably. And pause there. Rest in that place for a moment. And what's the restriction there? Is it muscular or skeletal? Is it between the ears? And what would you need to shift to enable you to go further to the right? Where is that place? Is it in your armpit? Is it in the waist? Is it in the neck and the hip? Is it in the shoulder blades? Gently slide yourself back to center. And move your attention onto the shoulder blades and really think about sliding one shoulder blade up and one shoulder blade down. And go to the right again and feel into the shoulder blades as you do that. And then the next time you go to the right, think about jutting the left ribs further out to the left. Kind of they're widening or fanning out, pushing to the left. See if that makes a difference. Then come back to the middle. And the next time you go to the right, think about the right ribs. Really think about folding them, softening, yielding, sinking. Right side of the waist folds. And could you bring all of these components into the movement? Sense the shoulders and both sides of your ribs and your waist all at the same time. And come back to center and pause. Unwind your arms from your head and bring them alongside. Lower the legs and rest. It's really amazing when we start to wake up our attention. It really changes the muscles. It changes what happens. And feel the sides of your neck, the two sides of your torso, even the quality of the breathing on the left side of the chest, on the right side of the chest. Stand both your feet on the floor. Interlace your hands, bring them behind the head, and the elbows wide, and slide your head and shoulders to the right and left, and feel now what's going on. Notice if one side learned something. And the next time you're in the middle, take the right hand out from behind your head, leave the left hand there, slide the head and shoulders to the left, and back to center. Begin to apply the same kind of ruthless attention so that you only go as far as is comfortable. You're sliding the shoulders on the floor, you're shifting the ribs. The right shoulder comes up as the left shoulder goes down. It's interesting, we switch sides and it's easy to forget we have two shoulders. They're not in our self-image all the time, and you can feel this when we shift to a different movement. Then go ahead and bring the right arm over the top of the head to hold the left elbow and continue to slide to the left and back and notice if that changes how the right shoulder gets involved. So the constraint of the nose toward the ceiling is still in place. And then pause in the middle, lower your arm slowly, slowly. Lower the legs and rest. Bend both your knees, stand both your feet, and then again bring your left hand behind your head. Slide your head over to the left and leave it there. And breathe into the right ribs a few times. So your right arm is comfortably alongside for this movement. Can you imagine the ribs widening and pushing out? Imagine the right side of the neck lengthening. Use the inhalation to expand the sense of inner volume out and to the right. The armpit, the base of the neck, the right collarbone, the right shoulder joint. And then leave it and slide yourself to the center again and lower the legs, bring the arm down. Once again, bring your left hand behind the head, bend your left knee, stand your left foot, your right arm over the top to hold the left elbow. If that's comfortable, if that's not comfortable for your right arm, don't go that far. If it doesn't go up at all, don't hold the arm at all. So you modify the movements for your own comfort. And if you can, the right hand is on the left elbow. Slide over to the left and stay there. And imagine lifting the left hip. Don't do it, but think it. Imagine the pressure through the foot. Imagine the left hip lifting, the belly button rolling to the right. Imagine the shifting of the ribs at the left waist. You feel the movement in your imagination all the way up through the ribs to the upper back. You can really clarify it in your image of the action. So you think before you act. Begin to barely push on the left foot. Enact a whisper of that movement. So it's just at the edge of thought and action. And then you release it completely. And then you re-engage. Barely push on the foot and see if that little bit of pressure can facilitate your image of the action all the way through your skeleton. Follow its outcome without applying a lot of force. When you've done that 6 or 7 or 8 times, slowly bring your head and shoulders back to the center and unwind your arms very slowly. Lower the left leg and rest. Feel your contact with the floor. Roll your head side to side and notice if it's different than the last time you did it. Bend both your knees and stand both your feet. Bring your left hand behind your head, your right arm up to hold the left elbow. Your elbows are wide. Slide your head and shoulders to the left and back to center. And then to the left and back to center, just to feel how it is. And then stay to the left. Lower the left leg. Imagine pushing through the right foot. Imagine the right knee pushes over the toes. Think it through, kind of feel the influence of that through your skeleton. Imagine the right hip lifting. And where would it go from there? then a few times, barely enact the movement so delicately, like someone looking at you wouldn't even know you're doing it. So you refine the threshold between thought and action. And then the action informs the thought, and the thought reinforms the action. It's kind of a feedback loop of clarification. And then when you've done that 7 or 8 times, you slowly slide the head and shoulders to the center and lower the right leg, bring the arms down ever so slowly, and rest. Feel your resting state. And bend your 2 knees and stand your 2 feet. Interlace the hands behind the head. And even though we didn't do as much on the left side, notice how it feels to go side to side now with the head and shoulders sliding the backs of the hands on the floor. Because we often transfer the learning to the other side. You don't have to do as many actual movements. You just have to effect the learning. What is it like to slide the head and shoulders? Fold the ribs? What do you do with your pelvis, your feet? The shoulder blades up and down, the elbows pointing up and down. And then leave it and lower the arms slowly alongside and lower the legs and rest. Feel the length of your 2 sides. Feel the shoulder blades on the floor. And do they have a different quality of resting than in the beginning? And when you're ready, roll to the side and come to sit and come to stand. And stand for a few moments and appreciate the support of your bones. And then move about and see how this lesson has affected you. Thank you.